when we go out and we ask God to forgive us of our sin, because He's created all of the wonders and even the thunderstorm that's approaching. He's created all of it, and He's created us. And He's created us, every molecule that holds us together. We're built by millions of other organisms. Who we are is not this flesh. This flesh goes away, back to the dust from His decay. This right here is the same stuff I'm made of, and that's all we all are. But God so loved us so much that He sent His only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe upon Him and the gift that was laid for us, that we could have life and life more abundantly here and life eternal over there. And that's what I'm looking for. I ain't worried about the abundance here. I have it right here. Y'all gathered here as brothers and sisters to me is the most wonderful, rewarding thing in the world. But I want to tell you something. The Bible tells us that God is not mocked. He is a mean and jealous God if you get on the wrong side. You know how it is when you do something wrong and Dad hollers at you? You know what I'm saying, yeah, because I used to be there too, that's right. And then when your mom gets on to you, and when they do, they're not saying they hate you. They just don't like what you're doing because they're trying to teach us. In just the same way our Father in Heaven is trying to teach each and every one of us how to live life, how to be blessed, even in death. We don't cry, I'm going home to be with Dad, right? Our Father in Heaven. And so what we're doing today, I'm asking you each to search your heart before we actually plummet ourselves into the water. You need to know what this means and why we're doing it. But ultimately, it's not going to do you a bit of good if you're not right with God to start with. You can go over and dunk yourself in your bathtub. You're going to get the same results. You need a bar of soap, I might have some in the car. I'm telling y'all, if you want to be baptized, you got to understand we are walking into the realm of earth and fire and water because we, as humans, baptize with water. The God, through the Holy Spirit, baptizes with fire. And I want to be on fire for God. Because it's an amazing walk and journey. When you draw close to Him, He'll draw close to you. The fears go away. Strength returns. And you fight, enduring even the worst of the worst. We all have ailments. We all have pain. We have loved ones that aren't where they need to be. And I'm asking you now, not for fame or fortune, not for claims of any kind of bragging rights, but I'm asking you right now, I want everybody's head to be bowed and listen to me just this moment and you will proceed. If you please close your eyes, I've asked this to be cut from the camera when it's all done and said. But is there anyone here, not looking around now, close your eyes, listen close. Is there anyone here right now that if you were to literally fall dead with an angel, to drop right face first into the dirt. And the next thing you know, in that very moment, you're looking at God. And He's going to say, either welcome to Him, thou good and faithful servant, or He's going to say, depart from me, the worker of iniquity. It's one thing to serve Him with our lips, it's a whole new thing to serve Him. So I'm asking everybody here as the sun beats down upon us because you don't know what hot is. This is unusual, nothing compared to what lays in wait in that lake of fire. But we miss it all. What we're going to do is be baptized. We're going to anoint each other as we go out. And I'm asking how it is. Are you really ready for that? If not, so that I can pray. Listen, we're going to say a prayer right now, okay? I want you to be ready for this. I want you to listen. Listen.